Hi, my name is Marlon. I work for RUB University in a team on mobile network security. And today I want to present our work on one of 5G's new privacy features that tries to defeat IMSI-Catchers. So if we look at the mobile network, of course, we all have the smartphone in our pockets. And on the network side, we have the base stations that provide the wireless coverage and a core network that performs management tasks. Now, your smartphone needs to identify somehow, and therefore it has a subscriber ID and a key stored on the SIM card. Now, in mobile networks, that identifier usually is the IMSI, that is a number that tells the network which operator you're registered with, and some kind of customer ID. Now, 5G also has the possibility for a user at domain style identifier, and both together is called the SUCI. But that is only important because of the name change. In this talk, we can just assume that we're still working with an IMSI that identifies the smartphone. Now, what happens if your smartphone joins the network? There is a simple protocol that identifies your smartphone with the IMSI. Only after that, encryption kicks in, because first the network has to look up your keys using that IMSI. So the first part of this protocol is a plain text protocol. Now, what happens if there is a IMSI catcher nearby? So an IMSI catcher is a fake base station that impersonates the real network. And at this stage of the protocol, the smartphone can't tell if it's the real network or an IMSI catcher. So basically the same protocol runs and the smartphone discloses the identity, the IMSI, to the IMSI catcher. And then the IMSI catcher can log that you were at within the range at the given time. And this is something that is, for example, used by law enforcement. So 5G has a new privacy feature that is called SUCI to encrypt the plain text identity. Basically, on the SIM card, you have an operator's public key stored, and together with an ephemeral key that is generated by the smartphone, you can encrypt the plain text SUCI or plain text IMSI. Now, what happens if you identify to an IMSI catcher? Of course, the protocol doesn't change. So you still disclose then the identity, but now the identity is encrypted. What is also very handy about this protocol is that the on every use, the SUCI is regenerated. So now the IMSI catcher cannot tell if two separate users just arrived or if the same user reappeared. So this feature will basically prevent IMSI catchers from collecting the plain text identity of all the users nearby. So what is not possible anymore is to directly ask the smartphone for its identity, because you get the encrypted identity back. But what is still possible through other attacks is to ask, to probe the smartphone for one specific identity. So in this example, you could ask, "Are you Merlin?" and the smartphone would leak if it belongs to me or not. Now we are going to have a look at this type of attack today. This style of attack is more intrusive, it scales worse, and it also requires cooperation from the smartphone and the network. So these type of attacks weren't practical before, but the question is, are they now practical since we have SUCI and can't use the way easier style of identification anymore? So of course you can't ask the smartphone if it belongs to Merlin, but what you can do is you can probe for an old SUCI, for an old identity. And gathering this old identity basically is detective's work. I mean, you can observe the smartphones that come in, and then at a later point you want to identify if somebody returned or not. So we're going to have a look at this linking attack. What happens is when a smartphone with a new identity, so an unknown smartphone with an unknown SUCI, comes into range of the IMSI catcher, well, it cannot tell the identity. But now what happens? The attacker will replace the new SUCI by the old identity and request an authentication from the network. Now this authentication request is associated with the old identity. The attacker forwards it to the smartphone, and then two cases can happen. So it could happen that you get an authentication failure back. That is because the smartphone is not associated with the old identity, and hence the authentication request is invalid. But it can also happen that the smartphone responds with an authentication, with a successful authentication, and then you know that the smartphone is indeed associated with that old SUCI, despite it tried to register with a regenerated new SUCI. So let's have a look at the experiments that we performed. So we built a 5G network and bought a 5G phone, and the 5G phone can connect over 5G radio to the standalone 5G core network. The core network is based on Amerisoft, and we built an attacker using free 5GC and the Amerisoft base station. So the first step that we did is to validate the attack. So that was described in theory before, and we could validate that this attack actually runs in an all 5G setup. Now we also performed some modifications on this attack that allow it to be repeated. So now instead of just asking the smartphone, "Are you Merlin?" you can ask, "Are you Merlin? Are you Alice? Are you Bob?" And we were able to repeat that for up to 500 identities. We wanted to know how well the attack scales, and that also means how fast the attack can run in a network. So what we did is that we speed tested the components involved, and we saw that, for example, for the SIM card, we could send about 800 requests a minute, and for the modem we could send about 500 requests a minute. So because the attack is limited by the slowest component involved, that means that we can run the 500 identity tests in just a minute. So of course that doesn't directly translate to real networks. So we wanted to find out how it will look like when commercial networks adopt the SUCI feature in 5G. So we performed speed tests in commercial 4G networks to see if the operators already employ rate limiting. And we found that on the SIM card, the speeds vary greatly. So some are rate limited, some don't seem rate limited. But on the network side, all of the three networks that we tested had quite heavy rate limiting. So that means that while the attack could work there, it wouldn't scale that well, and it would be slowed down by the rate limiting. To sum it up, we think that the SUCI feature will likely defeat IMSI-Catchers as we know them today. Still, small-scale identification of specific users could still be practical. So therefore, we think that if operators choose to deploy the SUCI feature, they should also have a look at rate limiting the authentication.